back to the topic. So SCN node gives the initial signal because of that atria contracts, and that signal is carried to AV node, atrioventricular node. Now once AV node gets the signal, it is propagated to this entire ventricles. Both the ventricles will get that signal and contract together. Simultaneously, both the ventricles will contract. With the help of Purkinje fibers, bundle office, all the bundles will carry out the impulses. Now see, what is happening? For cardiac contraction to occur, there are three steps are there. First, signal initiation. Initiation means to start a signal. The signal initiation starts from SCN node. The nodal cells will start a signal. After that, the signal is propagated to that entire atria. This is called signal propagation. Again, from this AV node, it is propagated to entire ventricles. That is called signal propagation. Finally, when it reaches to this base of this heart, the signal terminates. So three steps are there: signal initiation, signal propagation, signal termination. Once the cycle is done, again a new signal is given by SCN. So contract, relax, contract, relax. In a coordinated fashion, the contractions, relaxations occurs in the heart. So this is how the circulation is. These are all anatomical parts of the heart. Briefly, let me explain it again. So you need to understand. You need to have the picture in your brain. Right side, deoxygenated blood is there. From where it is getting, when the oxygenated blood goes to every parts of the body, all the tissues will take up that oxygen and it becomes deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood are carried by veins, right? The major vein is known as vena cava. Inferior vena cava, from the lower parts, it takes up deoxygenated blood, puts into this right atria. From top portion also you have superior vena cava there, which brings deoxygenated blood and puts in right atria. Once right atria contracts, the blood will be coming down to this right ventricle through this atrioventricular wall, and these walls are known as tricuspid walls. Cusp means a kind of tissue. Because three cusps are there, it is called as tricuspid wall. It allows the unidirectional flow of blood. Only from atria to ventricle, blood moves. After that, so the contraction is systole and then dilation is diastole. Now after that, this left ventricle contracts. The right ventricle contracts. When this right ventricle contracts, blood is taken to this pulmonary branch. This pulmonary artery takes the blood, reaches to pulmonary means lungs. The job is it will carry this deoxygenated blood to lungs. In the lungs, gases exchange occurs, oxygenation of blood occurs. The oxygenated blood is carried by pulmonary vein, and the blood gets into left atrium. When left atrium contracts, again, these walls allow the flow of blood into left ventricle. And left ventricle contracts, blood is taken to aorta, and aorta will provide oxygenated blood to entire body. One more thing. Look at these things. This is known as pulmonary artery. This is known as pulmonary vein. The normal concept with students is, with all of us is, we feel that arteries will carry oxygenated blood, veins will carry deoxygenated blood. Only the exception is pulmonary one. Look at here. What is this pulmonary artery is doing? It is carrying deoxygenated blood. What is this pulmonary vein is doing? It is carrying oxygenated blood. Now, let me clear the concept. It is not true that always arteries will carry oxygenated blood or veins will carry deoxygenated blood. No, it is not. The concept is based on arteries will take the blood away from the heart. What is this aorta, the major artery, is doing? It is taking blood away from the heart. Now veins will take the blood towards the heart. What is this vena cava is doing? It is taking blood towards the heart. Now come to this thing. Pulmonary artery, what is it doing? It is taking this deoxygenated blood away from the heart. Because it is taking away, it is called as artery. Not only that, see this vein. What veins does? They take blood towards the heart. What is this pulmonary vein is doing? It is taking blood from the lungs towards heart. So because of these directions, they are called as arteries and veins. Not only that, anatomical differences are also there. The anatomical differences are, look at this. When heart is generating pressure, the blood is getting into aorta. Right? So aorta blood vessel has got very grown up muscle walls. Their muscle wall is a strong muscle wall, whereas veins do not have that muscular walls. So anatomically, aorta has got very well developed muscle wall. Similar thing with this pulmonary artery. When you see that anatomy, the muscle wall is very well developed. Hence, it is called as artery. Artery. Veins, they do not have very well developed muscular wall. They are called as veins. Even pulmonary veins do not have enough muscle strength. Understand why this is happening. See, from the hands, the blood is coming down to this arm. It doesn't require muscle strength. Whereas, from this ventricle, against the gravity, it has to go to this lungs. It needs muscle strength. Hence, the artery has got that muscle strength. Now, so understand this. Artery veins are not based on the blood they contain. It is based on two points. One, arteries always take the blood away from the heart. They are taking blood away from the heart. That is the reason why the pulmonary artery, which is taking blood away from the heart, is called as pulmonary artery. Second one, veins always take the blood towards the heart. It is taking towards the heart. Second difference, anatomical difference. Arteries have got very well developed muscle walls. Veins do not have it. So when there is no amount of blood or very less amount of blood is there, arteries can remain as such, but veins will get collapsed. Why they are collapsing? Because enough muscle is not there. Now the next one. See this thing. This part is with pulmonary artery and pulmonary vein. Hence, this is known as pulmonary circulation. Pulmonary circulation. Whereas this part, like aorta and vena cava, this is known as systemic circulation. Systemic circulation. In the morning class also I have explained. Whenever you think about a drug, we say that the drug needs to reach systemic circulation. That means it has to get here and here, not here. Drug should not reach to lungs, except when you inhale the drugs or when the target should be lungs. Otherwise, all the drug should reach systemic circulation. So the systemic pulmonary is based on these parameters. So what are the things we have seen? We have seen the anatomy of heart. We have seen physiology and how the circulation is occurring, and what are pulmonary and systemic circulations. So this is about anatomy and physiology of the heart. And we have seen about nodal tissues also. Signal is generated, propagated, and terminated. Again, let me tell you the other things. Imagine this hand is atria and this hand is ventricle. So when atria contracts, ventricle will be dilated. That means when atria is in systolic phase, ventricle will be in diastole. When ventricle is contracting, atria dilates. This is how the rhythm of heart is. So when atria is contracting, ventricle is relaxing. When ventricle contracts, atria relaxes. So this is how the heart works. This is called the rhythm of heart. It is not this. It is not this. It is only this. If in a coordinated fashion, the rhythm will be there. If any problem in this rhythm results in arrhythmia, arrhythmia means error in rhythm. So both the atria will contract together, then ventricle will dilate. When ventricle, both of them will contract, atria will get dilated. This is what happens in the heart. Now, the other